गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद चैप्टर 7 ऑफ बिहाइव पैकेट। दिस चैप्टर इज एन एक्सट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम जेरोम के जेरम्स नॉवल थ्री मैन इन अ बो। दिस स्टोरी इज अ ह्यूमरस अकाउंट ऑफ थ्री फ्रेंड्स अटेम्प्टिंग टू पैक देयर लगेज बिफोर गोइंग ऑन फॉर अ वेकेशन। वाइल द नरेटर स्मार्टली ऑफर्स टू पैक द लगेज, होपिंग ओनली टू इंस्ट्रक्ट अदर टू डू इट, ही एंड्स अप डूइंग थिंग्स ऑल बाय हिमसेल्फ इन अ क्वाइट मेसी मैनर। द थ्री मैन जेरोम, जॉर्ज एंड हैरिस प्लान टू गो ऑन अ प्लेजर बोट जर्नी एंड हैव टू पैक फॉर इट। ऑल थ्री ऑफ देम थिंक दैट दे आर मास्टर्स इन द आर्ट ऑफ पैकिंग, बट देयर एक्शंस ओनली क्रिएट क्योस मेस एंड कन्फ्यूजन। They are disorganized, unplanned, foolish, careless, unsystematic, and cannot properly pack a thing. They blame each other for being poor at packing and each boasts of his packing equipment. The chapter highlights that routine tasks may not be as easy as they seem to be. The way the three friends act and react to the situations is quite funny. The humorous account amuses the readers with the chaotic and confusing situations created by the clumsiness of three friends, all of whom consider packing to be a child's play. So, let us start the lesson. I said I would pack. I rather pride myself on my packing. Packing is one of those many things that I feel I know more about than any other person living. It surprises me myself sometimes how many such things there are. I impressed the fact upon George and Harris and told them that they had better leave the whole matter entirely to me. They fell into the suggestion with a readiness that had something uncanny about it. George spread himself over the easy chair and Harris cocked his legs on the table. I said I would pack, means the narrator, the author, Jerome, he offered that he would pack the things as he was very proud of his packing. Pride myself means very feeling very proud. He was very proud of his packing and he thinks that he can do packing better than others. So, he impressed this fact upon George and Harris and told them that they should leave the whole matter to him. He would do it himself. They fell into suggestion. Fell into suggestion means accepted. Now George and Harris, they readily accepted their suggestion. They agreed to it. And the author, he felt very strange about it. Now George and Harris, they felt relaxed. George is in a relaxed manner. He sat on an easy chair. And Harris also put his legs on the table and sat in a relaxed manner. This was hardly what I intended. What I had meant, of course, was that I should boss the job and Harris and George should potter about under my directions. I pushing them aside every now and then with, "Oh, you, here, let me do it. There you are, simple enough," really teaching them, as you might say. They are taking it in the way they did irritated me. There's nothing does irritate me more than seeing other people sitting about doing nothing when I'm working. Now the narrator said that this was not his intention that he should do the whole work himself. Actually, what does he want? He wanted to boss over the job and he wanted that Harris and George, they should work under his directions, ठीक है, and I and every now and then I would scold them that you cannot do a thing properly. Let me do it. Let me teach you. Actually, he wanted to teach them, and they are taking it in the way they irritated me. But they behaved like this way. They sat in a relaxed manner, and this irritated the narrator very. There's nothing does irritate me more than seeing other people sitting about doing nothing when I am working. He says, this irritates me a lot that I am doing work and other people, they are sitting in a relaxed manner. I lived with a man once who used to make me mad that way. He would loll on the sofa and watch me doing things by the hour together. He said it did him real good to look on at me messing about. And he said, I lived with a man. Now he remembered an incident that he used to live with a man, and that person irritates him a lot by sitting in a relaxed manner while he was working. And he said he used to sit on a sofa in a relaxed manner and watch him doing things by hours together. He said it did him real good to look on at me messing about. And that person said that he enjoyed his messing about the things. Now, I'm not like that. I cannot sit still and see another man slaving and working. I want to get up and superintend and walk around with my hands in my pockets and tell him what to do. It is my energetic nature. I cannot help. He said that I am not like that. I cannot sit still and see that other people, they are working. I am very energetic and I want to get up. I want to supervise each and everything. And I want to walk around with my hands in the pocket and teach them how to do a thing properly. As he was very energetic and he cannot help that thing. However, I didn't say anything but started the packing. It seemed a longer job than I had thought it was going to be, but I got the bag finished at last and I sat on it and strapped it. He said that he didn't say anything and started packing, and he thought that it would be a job of a few minutes, but it is a longer job. And as soon as he finished his last bag, he sat on it and he just packed it. He strapped it. "Aren't you going to put the boots in?" said Harris. And I looked round and round. I had forgotten them. That's just like Harris. He couldn't have said a word until I had got the bag shut and strapped, of course. And George laughed. One of those irritating, senseless laughs of his. They do make me so bad. And as soon as he finished his bag, he strapped them. Then Harris said that, "Are you not going to put the boots in? You have forgotten to put the boots in." Now, Jerome looked here and there and he found that he had really forgotten to put the boots in. Now, he got very much irritated and he said, Harris is just like that. He could have told him before he had packed the bags. And seeing this, George laughed and he got more irritated and he said, "They make me so wild." Wild means so, you can say, mad. "I opened the bag and packed the boots in, and then just as I was going to close it, a horrible idea occurred to me. Had I packed my toothbrush? I don't know how it is, but I never do know whether I have packed my toothbrush or not." Now he opened his bag, he packed the boots in, and then just as I was going to close it, a horrible idea occurred to him. He was troubled by an idea. He had forgotten whether he had packed his toothbrush in it or not. He said, "I don't know how it is, but I never do know whether I have," means I am very much confused. I don't know whether I have packed the toothbrush in it or not. "My toothbrush is a thing that haunts me when I am traveling and makes my life a misery. I dream that I haven't packed it and wake up in a cold perspiration and get out of the bed and hunt for it. And in the morning, I pack it before I have used it and have to unpack again to get it. And it is always the last thing I turn out of the bag, and then I repack and forget it and have to rush upstairs for it at the last moment and carry it to the railway station wrapped up in my pocket handkerchief. Now he remembers his previous experiences also. He said, my toothbrush is a thing that always gives me trouble. Haunts means gives me trouble when I am traveling, and it makes my life a miserable thing. It makes my life very sad. I dream that I haven't packed it, that I had a nightmare that I haven't packed it, and I woke up in a cold perspiration, in a cold sweat. I get out of my bed and started searching for it, and in the morning I pack it before even using it. So he has to use his toothbrush in the morning, so he has to unpack all the things, and it is always the last thing I turn out of the bag, means he could not find it in the bag. He had to take out each and everything out of the bag, and then he finds his toothbrush. Then he repacked it again and forgot it. Then he had to rush to upstairs to his room at the last moment and carry the toothbrush wrapped up in his pocket handkerchief. So this was the previous experience he was remembering. Of course, I had to turn every mortal thing out now, and of course I couldn't find it. I rummaged the things into much the same state they are, that they must have been before the world was created. And when the chaos reigned, of course I found George and Harry's 18 times over, but I couldn't find my own. I put the things back one by one and held everything up and shook it. Then I found it inside a boot. I repacked once again. Now what he had to do? He had to take out each and everything out of the bag to find his toothbrush. Now he searched in a hurried way, and it created a lot of chaos. All the things got mixed up, and there was a chaotic situation. And he found George and Harry's toothbrush many times, but he couldn't find his own toothbrush. Now what he did, he put the things back one by one so that he can find his toothbrush, and he held up everything, he shook each and everything. Then he found that his toothbrush was inside the bowl. So he had to repack all the things again, as he has messed up all the things, so he had to repack them. When I had finished, George asked if the soap was in. I said I didn't care whether the soap was in or whether it was not. I slammed the bag shut, strapped it, and found that I had packed my spectacles in it and had to reopen it. It got shut up finally at 10 to 5 p.m. and then there remained the hampers to do. Harris said we should be wanting to start in less than 12 hours time, and thought that he and George had better to do the rest, and I agreed and sat down, and they had a go. So when he had finished packing, then George again asked him if he had put the soap in it or not. Now he got irritated. He said, now I don't care whether I have packed the soap or not. He strapped the bags and found that he had packed his spectacle by mistake. He had put his spectacles inside the bag, so he had to reopen the bag again. He had to reopen the bag and repack it, and finally at approximately at 10 o'clock he shut up all the bags. He closed all the bags, and now the hampers are still remaining. Hampers means the large baskets in which they had to put their food items. Now George and Harris said that now they are getting late, and now they would help him and they would pack the rest of the things. Now Jerome, he agreed to this thing. They begin in a light-hearted spirit, evidently intending to show how to do it. I made no comment. I only waited. With the exception of George, Harris is the worst packer in this world. And I looked at the piles of plates and cups and kettles and bottles and jars and pies and stoves and cakes and tomatoes, etc., and felt that the things would soon become exciting. Now they started, George and Harris, they started in a light-hearted spirit. Means they said that they will do it in minutes. And they want to show him that how exactly, how accurately did they do all the things. I made no comments. He didn't say anything. He only waited and he was just looking at the things. And he said, Harris was the worst packers in this world. He could not pack all the things. And he looked at there was a pile of plates, cups, kettles, bottles, jars, pies, stoves, cakes, tomatoes, etc. And everything has been piled up. Everything has been scattered. And he was feeling amused that the things would soon become exciting. It did. They started with breaking a cup. That was the first thing they did. They did that just to show you what they could do and to get you interested. Then Harris packed the strawberry jam on the top of the tomato and squashed it, and they had to pick out the tomato with a teaspoon. He said the things were soon going to become exciting, and it really happened when they had just started. They started it with breaking a cup. This is the first thing that they did. They were going to pack the things and they have just broken a cup. They did that just to show what they could do and to get you interested. Means he was feeling amused that they are just going to make the things very interesting. Now what they did, Harris packed a heavy strawberry jam bottle on the top of the tomatoes. Now the tomatoes, they are soft, they got squashed and they created a mess. Now they have to pick that tomato with a teaspoon. All the things became dirty. So this was how they started their packing. Next part of the thing we'll do in the next class. Thank you.